Welcome to the Afro-Scot podcast.
Okay, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Appreciate you for having me on.
Nice. We're gonna talk about standing out in the African community.
Standing out. Alright, cool. Oh yeah. First of all, every person should stand out, anyways, in general. But I mean that as like an individual. I feel like every individual should aspire to like stand out, right? Well, in the African community, I feel like I wouldn't necessarily say stand out, because I feel like, in a way, standing out is kind of being a downfall. You don't really do well if you only have like one standout person to get.
All right.
Well, I feel like I'm more on the side of developing a mindset that allows all of us like excel in our own individual ways. To get. Because standing out, I associate standing out as crabbing the barrel mentality. With like crabbing the barrel mentality, to get. Mm-hmm. Whereas like that one person is up there, you know, he's skeptical who is going to come and take his spot. Like, do you get what I'm saying? But as opposed to like having this mindset where like, you know, you're fighting for a collective goal, and eventually everybody's doing well in their own, like without anyone wanting to depend on anyone, do you get? And everyone is happy. So the idea of standing out, I don't know what context you mean, but standing out, not really. I don't really, I believe like as a community in general, I believe we need to stand out. And if you mean stand out from that perspective, then I think it's very important for Black people to step up, because first of all, you have to check like the history, you have to check everything we've suffered, you have to check. In fact, look at you, your example of yourself. Why is it important for you to stand out? You're a Black man, you constantly have like, you know, problems every day, even apart from just being African. And then now you're African, in the sense of being African, you know, you're looking at your own country and you're here. So it's like almost you have problems here, but like racism, all that kind of bullshit going on. And then you have problems in Nigeria. Well, for example, exactly in Nigeria, where there's corruption and shit. So you mean like, do you get what I'm saying? Like, I'm saying like, as in, like you feel like there's struggles either way as like a Black person or an African. All I'm trying to say is that like, I lost my train of thought. I was going to say something.
Yeah, as a Black man, we go through a lot of struggles here, definitely, and with racism and all of that. So of course,
that should push you off to stand out, anyways.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Like that should be an added motivation to be like, you just want to be free, because like I feel like honestly, being a Black man, like yeah, everything is all free, but like individually and mentally, we're not really free like that, because we always want to make sure somebody's is not judging us this way. Or make sure so we don't have this stereotype. Like, we're not just allowed to just be Black people for just being Black people, yeah? Right. You're in your life, you're always trying to like make sure that you're not fitting this narrative, or you want to fit this narrative. Like, there's always something you want to be, as opposed to like other races who just do their own stuff, you know? So yeah. I think that should be an added motivation for you to stand out, really.
Yeah.
I mean,
yes, me as well. I understand what you mean by it should be a collective, and it shouldn't be standing out as in one person should be on top and everybody else on top. It should be more of a group type thing. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. It should be more of a group type thing, because like standing out as an individual is like it's not really constructive for a community, because it always has like its own problems, and as opposed to other like cultures, like it deeply affects our own culture. Like that one brother that's in charge, like first Black professor. What was the first Black professor?
Right. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? As opposed to like, oh, we have a bunch of scholars who are from Nigeria. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, like those kind of stuff is just like, it should be an added motivation for you to just be like, you know what, I want to change this narrative, and I want my community to stand out as opposed to standing out. But I suppose you can only help people if you help yourself. Yeah?
Right, I understand what you mean now. You're saying that if you are a black person, you should be wanting to promote the African culture and the community.
Yeah,
yourself, because that's what you.
Yeah. It should always be about like, okay, now I'm here. How can the next black person be here?
Right, got it.
At the end of the day, you don't have to solve everybody's problems, but like just subconsciously, you just have to have that like subconsciously in your head, like, you know, like, okay, I'm here now. I need somebody like me that looks like that has to be here. All right, cool. I want to, like just to be comfortable and free in society, really. And I think when we have more of that, then black people are more confident, and everybody just lives in harmony. Like there's more respect. Community, and nobody can really disrespect it anymore.
That's true. I agree with that. The next one was, who stops us from standing up? You know what I mean? Because in the African community, let's say we want to start something, and then who are usually the culprits that kind of want to pull us down and say that we can't do this? And for example, Malcolm X, everybody knows about him. His teacher said to him that when he wanted to become a lawyer or something at that level, his teacher said to him, that doesn't happen to people like you. You know what I mean? So who stops us? You know what I mean? Who stops us while growing up? Or do you believe that nobody stops us, that we can just go for it?
I think what stops us is our mindset.
Right.
It's our mental that stops us, right? We suffer from all this like PTSD and trauma like in society every day. That has just kind of like stopped us from like aspiring to be what we can aspire to be like. So I'll give an example. I want to start a restaurant right now.
Okay.
That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
If it's so sad, but if I limit my target audience to just Africans, I won't succeed. But if I limit it to like the whole culture, I'll succeed, right? Problem with that is because we don't believe in ourselves so much, like sometimes it's not even intentional, we just have it in our head, we're like, nah, we can't actually do this. This can't actually work. Like we're always looking for the negatives in our stuff as opposed to looking at the positive. And like when it comes to other people or other races, they're always looking at positive from their own stuff to make it bigger. While us, we're looking at the negatives, and then we just keep inflicting self-pity to that negative, and we just stay in same place, really. And I think that's really what stops us. I think it's the mental trauma we've suffered for so long. Unless we start like admitting that, yo, we have all these traumas, okay, how the hell do we start, you know, how do we address all these issues? Feel comfortable express yourself like emotionally. Like how do we go back to just being normal human beings again? Do you get what I'm saying?
Right. Okay.
Like I think when we get to that aspect, that's when I don't think anyone will be able to like stop us. Because I don't believe anyone can stop us. I just think even if it's the case where someone is stopping us, I would imagine they're using our disadvantage to their advantage. So, yeah. I don't think no one can really stop us from standing out.
Yeah, no one can really stop it. That's very true. So, how about standing out in terms of, you know, let's say in the African community, you know, most people in the African community can either go for being a doctor or engineer or, you know, those types of routes. And there's not a lot of people in different fields, you know what I mean, not just the arts, different types of fields. There's not that many Africans in there. Why do you think that is? Is it because we don't want to go there, or do you think it's because for example, let's say there's somebody in the African community, they mostly see people succeeding being a doctor or engineer, and then they want to try something else, but because everybody else is sort of doing well in this area, they might just decide, nah, I'm not going to go this way, I want to go the way everybody else is going. How do you think that can be solved? You know, how do you think somebody like that decide to want to stand out?
again, man, bro, it's our mental conditioning again, right? Because, like, I mean, at the end of the day, like, before all this colonialism or everything happened, like, before all this separatism, I think we're very, like, liberals, like, hands-on people, right? And gradually, not even apart from colonialism, like, the way the world has changed, I guess wealth is riches right now, right? Well, to rich billionaires and all that kind of stuff. But to, like, for me and you, like, working class people, like, coming up right now, we see money as riches, right? Mm. And our parents, like, growing up as well, they saw stuff like that. And reason why I think this is happening in terms of, like, oh, you have to be a doctor, all that kind of stuff, is because of how the world has changed right now, that's the only way you can succeed.
Right.
Like, you can only make good amount of money to buy wealth, like being a lawyer, doctor, all that kind of stuff. Well, that's what the world has made us believe, even though it's not true, because we all know that's not true, right? But legitimately, the settings of the world has changed, and now being a doctor, that's when you get more money, and, like, all these traditional professions were considered to be like the wealthiest. That's my parents' generation. But then now what we fail to understand is, because our grandparents did that, like, that was the norm in their own lifestyle, in their own life, right? Mm-hmm. So now coming up to us now, where, you know, being a doctor is cool and all that, we have the internet now, right? And we're very creative on the internet, or we're seeing different ways of making money from doing anything we like, as opposed to just being a doctor, lawyer, and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Problem with the African parents is, I mean, till today, Africa is still playing catch up with technology, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they came from a country where technology wasn't, like, really the big thing to, like, fall through. And they came here, so they still have that, like, Nigerian mentality, and that Nigerian mentality worked for them, right? For us, we're born into this technology and we see the world completely different from how our parents. I mean, not even the technology, we're just born in this country where, like, we see the world completely different from how our parents would traditionally see it.
Right.
And that's, I feel like, it's something that you can't really accept, because, you know, your elders always feel like, yeah, we know better than you.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
You know what I mean? You can't really accept the fact that, like, yo, internet is going to give you money. Being a responsible person is being a doctor. And because being a doctor as well, it comes with this stigma, you know, like us as Africans, like, status is always big, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the mental conditioning of our African society is, if you're a lawyer, you're a responsible person in society. If you're a doctor, you're a responsible person in society. And that idea of being responsible is so, like, it's so innate. Everybody loves to, like, have that.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why they like to enforce it. It's just their mental conditioning, really, that makes it, like, a very hard barrier to, like, jump over, if you get what I mean.
Yeah, I get what you mean. Yeah,
that,
yeah.
Damn, I went really deep. It was just a simple question, but yeah, like, I think it's the mental conditioning that makes that, like, a stigma, I think, especially in the black society.
Yeah, definitely. I agree. Well, so are there examples of people who have succeeded in standing out, you know, in the African community,
well, African community, like, worldwide, or UK, Nigeria, where are you saying?
Everywhere, you know, we're all Africans, we all come from there, so.
Jay-Z. That's my biggest, like, hero of, like, Jay-Z, because.
Z, okay.
He makes being black very cool.
Okay.
Fela, to me, Fela stood out because Fela stood out, made Africa stand out, African music stand out.
True.
That's my idea of standing out. Like, it's not just, oh yeah, you did something. Like, someone like Fela created, like, a genre, and now everybody can be a millionaire from just copying that genre. So that's standing out to me.
Mm-hmm.
Who would I say stands out to me? Like, I think all these, like, my local hero, I don't know, like, Thomas Sankara, I don't know if you know him.
No.
He was, like, a he was president. He was president of an African country. I can't remember what African country was. Anyways, but he was very good. He fought for freedom, fought for everything, and his whole ideology was amazing. So he made the idea. He made people realize that your freedom is like. He stood up pretty much explaining why freedom was beneficial, and now they understand that yeah, they had to be, like they understood that they had to be free from like from the French people and stuff. So that stands out to me, like the idea of like just helping everyone else, but you're still in the limelight. I love that. Nelson Mandela, I guess. Mm-hmm. All the stuff. These are people that stand up to me.
Yeah, even like Haile Selassie as well.
Haile Selassie. To be honest, like I don't really know about him. What did he do? How did he stand up?
He was the Ethiopian emperor.
Yeah.
And Rastas, so you know the Rastas, dreadlocks and stuff like that, and they were inspired by him, because they say he comes from the same dynasty as Solomon from the Bible.
Weird.
Yeah, and Solomon is connected to King David, who was then connected to Jesus Christ. So a lot of people call him the Messiah, and Selassie the Messiah.
They changed the idea of religion. I mean, giving us the idea of black Jesus. Jesus looks like
black. Yeah.
Fair enough.
Yeah, okay. That's how they see Selassie, and he also stopped a lot of Italians from conquering
Ethiopia. Yeah.
Ethiopia was one of the ones who didn't get.
Yeah, one of the African countries that never got colonized.
Yeah. So yeah, he's a pretty cool guy. And Kanye West as well, you know, hate him or love him, Kanye West is actually a really good example.
Why?
Well, a lot of people hate him, but
because I have mixed feelings with Kanye. Why does he stand up?
Well, the thing about Kanye is, though he says a lot of crazy stuff, what I like about him is he's not afraid of being unpopular. Saying something unpopular, you know what I mean?
Okay.
That's what I like about him.
I hear that still. That's pretty cool. Cool perspective to have.
And he doesn't mind saying how he feels. And I think that's really, really strong, because that's something that a lot of Africans, because we are naturally docile. I mean, we don't really like to speak up and
facts.
So when you see somebody who is not afraid to speak up and, you know, just go his own way, I think it's quite inspiring. You know, he does say some crazy stuff. You know what I mean? And, you know, he bites himself, but shoots himself in his own foot. But at the end of the day, as long as he can go home and say that I said what I wanted to say and how I felt, you know, I think it's okay. And I think a lot of children can actually look up to somebody like that, you know. Because Fela was kind of the same thing, you know. It was kind of the same way.
I hear that actually in terms of like even confidence as well. I think as a black person, like, you know, you're damn, like, so it's okay, it's normal for me to like speak, to express myself. That's pretty cool. Fair enough. It's a cool perspective to have, Kanye. Because me, I'm not really a fan of him. But then I didn't really realize that like he probably might have impacted me in just being like free speech and all that kind of stuff.
Kanye's one of them, and obviously Fela Kuti for me as well, because you know the story about him making that song called Zombie.
Yeah,
I mean, like, that's bold,
right? Especially at that time in Nigeria, where like this game got down quickly.
Yeah,
on site.
Yeah, look,
rapid fire.
He's in history books now, so.
Exactly, you know, you made the idea of, you know, making music cool, speaking up, standing up for your right. Bob Marley is probably one of mine as well.
Yeah.
You know, standing up for your right. Don't let, like, you're not lesser than anyone, and you're not greater than anyone. You're just, you're all as equal. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, so have you got like sort of like something you can tell people, like, no, that for Scots? You know, let's say anybody's watching this and maybe they're afraid to go out there and be them. You know, what can you say to them?
One of my biggest things is just create the culture. creating a culture will be beneficial for us being economically like competitive amongst like society in the UK and Scotland in general, to be fair. Because if you have a culture, we don't have to depend on the government for business schemes and all that. Because as a community, we'll be able to provide ourselves that. Businesses will flourish because if we create a culture where our food is cool, people will buy it. If we create a culture where we make our music cool, people will listen to it, and whoever is a rapper, it's gonna be a rapper and you make money off it. Like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a great opportunity for us if we create a culture. That's something we need to do right now. And I feel like the London, like the Southerners have done it already, even the South. You know what I'm saying? Like, grime is cool now, everyone's making money from it. Like, why can't Scotland do it? So yeah, man, we need to do that so that we can be economically like liberated. If not, we just have to keep applying to IBS, JP Morgan, living in our postcodes, and they say, yeah, that's the black neighborhood and all that negative stigma is attached to us. But if we want to be rich, that's what we need to do. If we want to be a better generation than our parents, that's what we need to do. So yeah, that's my best advice. Love. It's funny how I can give advice to people, but I can't even give advice to myself. That's funny.
Yeah, exactly. You know. And no, and even if you look at kind of other cultures as well, like and the like Jewish people, they are very like interconnected. You know what I mean, the
Asians, just even closest thing to us here. Like, look at Asians. Every store, they have every store, every business, radio station, schools, mosque, wherever, they have their own stuff. Don't have nothing.
No,
like us, we don't spend our money in the Asian shop. We go to McDonald's. Then we go to the Italian for fancy date night. We go to the Italian restaurant. to buy our own clothes, we go buy Balenciagas and all that. Like, we can make so like fashion, for example. If you have a culture, look at your own brand, Afro-Scot design. That can be just as big as Kuti. It sounds funny. It sounds so funny, but like, why can Afro-Scot not be as big as Supreme or some shit or stuff like that? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We make Balenciaga's cool.
Thank
we
you
make,
for that. Yeah.
No, it's true. But like, we make Balenciaga's cool. We make Gucci cool. They're all cool. We can make ours cool too. So like, we can all like, if Afro-Scot like brand is as big as that, You need creative directors, you need camera people, you need, and these will all probably be black people because these are people that you probably come in contact with daily, right? You need managers for your brand, you need directors of your seat, like you need security, like you need so many, like these are black men giving you jobs, like they're paid well. You know? Like, so much. We just need to create a culture. Like, that's what I think.
Oh, that's it.
We really need to do, yeah. We make our own music, our own Scottish hip hop or whatever. It sounds funny now, but like, it's lit though. If you actually, like, if you pay attention to it, it is actually lit. It's very, it's good music.
Actually,
it's popular.
I actually even think we are going down that way. I mean, in the coming decade, you know, especially this 2020, we're actually heading that way. It sounds crazy right now, and like you're saying as well, but I actually believe that if we keep it up as we're doing, it's actually possible, you know, because there's already some rappers already in Scotland who are actually doing really well. You know, you and I know some, you know what I mean? I don't want to drop any things, but, you know, we all know some. And, you know, I believe these guys are really doing really well.
Nah, rappers like Sky, Pat, yeah. Chef, the Kid guy, you have this guy called like AB Gang. Bro, we have like a lot, man. Like there's so many Ransom FA, like there's so many people. Sorry?
T Kid.
Exactly, T Kid. All of them. They're all dope music. They're all dope musicians, man. But get behind them, like they make good music, like listen to them. Like vibe in the gym today. Yo, there's this track by this guy. No, there's this track by this guy, Active. Mm-hmm. Like Chef. Bro, if you bang that bang in the gym, my mm-hmm. guy, like you're going like 100 miles per hour, like nonstop. Like it's dope, man. It's actually dope music. Mm-hmm. So yeah, like yeah. I think culture needs to be created, man. So, you know, we can all benefit from that because, hey, man, people are running out of jobs. Not everybody can get a job in JP Morgan. Not everybody could get a job in Apple. Not everybody, like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, not in all these traditional places. Not everybody can get a job there. We need to fend for ourselves. We can't depend on the government to help us.
And like you're saying, we need to start a culture if we want that. Our own culture. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, it was nice talking to you. It was nice talking to you before.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is the Afro-Scot podcast and probably more
Clubhouse. I'm at peace, man. Thanks for having me, brother. Peace.